Hi, hello, how are you all this fine day? I hope that if you're here, you subscribe to this channel if you're not already, and you check out everything that's down below. Description box, comment section, like button, subscribe button. You know what's going on. You've been here before, I hope. And if not, well, hello. And today I wanted to chat about the concept of being a late bloomer. And just acknowledging that, one, we're just kind of set up in a society that is conditioning us to like compare ourselves to everyone else and make it competitive in some sort of sense, when it very much should not be. That's a whole side tangent. But mostly, just acknowledging the fact that if you're disabled or neurodiverse, whatever, however you identify, it might be likely that someone could consider you a late bloomer for whatever reason. I'll give my own examples, again with a disclaimer that this is just my experience, and I grew up in a small Midwest town where I can probably say like half of the people that I graduated high school with, and probably even, well, depending on college, were already, by my age, in my mid-20s, have already been married, possibly divorced already, and with children. That's not normal. that's not the norm in most places, which I'm grateful for you for. But being around that and seeing people, and that's just one area of life, mind you, but seeing people like pass you by in doing all these things and having these different relationships and being able to actually cultivate those when like you can barely even complete a single task in one day. And I can say that in the case of more of my like academic and not so professional, mostly academic, just because I learned how to do school and I just kind of stuck with it. I'm realizing now as I reflect that I purposely sped through doing the absolute most in high school and then graduating with my undergraduate in 3 years with honors, two majors, like all the things. And I sped through all of that, I think, to both prove to myself and prove to the world that I was not behind, that I was competent enough to do what everyone else was doing at that normal pace. And I again look back and I don't think I should have done that. I was 50 shades of mentally ill. I probably should have taken a year off before I even went to college. And I didn't want to, because I already felt like I was behind and I could sense it, even if on paper it didn't look like it. And I had to do that. I had to do that to prove that I am at pace with everyone else. I am not falling behind. And in this case, I'm not like a late bloomer. I'm with everyone else. And long story short, even though it's already been 5 minutes. It's okay to do your own thing and to do it at your own pace, even if that is behind other people that you know. I've basically I chose to do this video and talk about this just because I've actually come to the point that I never thought I would, which is that, like, I'm very satisfied with where I am, with the people in my life, and I don't want to scroll through and look at everyone else's anymore, because that's kind of what I did. I wanted to keep tabs on, like, everyone else and just see, like, okay, I'm behind in this, but again, drawing comparisons when I am one of very few, I imagine, that were neurodiverse or disabled that I know. And that's not fair to myself, and it's not fair to you to do that either if you are also prone to doing that and in turn probably obsessing over it, probably hyperfixating on it, and it goes into a downward spiral. I read somewhere, don't quote me, I am the least bit a scientist possible, but I believe it's been shown that neurodiverse people, their brains developmentally tend to lag at least 2 or 3 years behind a neurotypical brain. So, and that does not include functioning, which is different. But just in the case of, say, like, executive functioning or whatever you want to throw in, at my age, I should be all done and I should be fully, like, capable adult, whatever. But it could be very likely that there is still 2+ years worth of, like, work that my brain has to do to get to whatever place it's supposed to be. So it's not even within my means necessarily to try and speed myself up and work myself to the bone and burn out for years on end that I'm still feeling, when that's not even fair. It's not realistic at all. But we don't get to see that. We don't really know what that looks like. We might if there would be more people that were diagnosed with neurodiversity of some kind, and we saw that on a regular basis. But even then, it's not set in stone. We want different things. We have different skills and all these things, and throw in all the extra factors into the mix. So whether you think you're thinking of, like, social things of, I'm behind on, like, forming lasting friendships, or I'm behind on my experience with romance or sexuality or whatever it is, or you're on the other side of, if you're like me and the professional type of landscape has been extremely challenging, so I'm probably way behind on that, and academically or whatever it is, anything here where there is a tendency to think that you have not yet reached your fullest potential, you know, it might not even be within your unique individual means to meet this arbitrary place of, I am blooming, I am flourishing. It might not look like what you think it's going to look like. And that's okay. And if it takes you longer, or maybe even shorter than other people, because neurodiversity is a good thing, then that's okay too. It's, I just want to tell you today, if you've made it this far, that you shouldn't feel any sort of shame or guilt or anxiety, any sort of negative thought that you have about potentially being behind, not being at the same pace, not the same path, and you might feel like you're disappointing yourself or other people, or just, I don't know, getting lost, getting, disappearing, I don't know. Whatever you're feeling right now, just let yourself be. Let yourself naturally go at your pace, do what you need to do, or be who you need to be ultimately, and most importantly, and you will get where you need to go, ultimately. I believe that wholeheartedly. I feel like I'm partially there now when I've never felt that way before. So, hey, if I can get somewhat there, I think anyone can. Because let me tell you, just with this vision, yeah, I didn't think this would ever have be at all in my life. So please share your thoughts down below if you have any. Like and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you all next time.